the importance of rule of law for countries, the importance of the recognition of that mm-hmm. by a much wider community, the business community, the professional bodies, not just lawyers, but other professional groups, mm-hmm. the importance for women, of women, peace and security, the important institution created while I was serving as UN High Commissioner for Human Rights. I described it as the most important new institution of the 20th century, yep. And it's now the 21st century, and it's a young institution in yep. that. But these are, I think, the ideas about rule of law, which take it out of mm-hmm. Being in a cul-de-sac and make it more part of yep. The importance of human security yep. in our world today. Thank you.
So it's only natural that you should now hear from the Department of Homeland Security. I think it's a testament to the vision of this gathering and of Louise Bluen and the Bluen Foundation mm-hmm. and the Creative Leadership Summit. In this conversation of security, law, justice, war, and conflict, you have three women mm-hmm. On this panel, and that we come from as diverse backgrounds as we do. And though I am serving in my government now as the Deputy Secretary of the third largest department, the Department of Homeland Security, something probably many of you have heard of, not everybody knows what it means to talk about Homeland Security. I'll touch on that briefly. Mm-hmm. But just to say by way of my own background, I began my career as a soldier in the United States Army. I spent a lot of time thinking and writing about how to fight wars, how they end, what factors combine to keep war from ending, and how war very often, in fact always, is a manifestation of lawlessness, of the absence of the rule of law, whether there's no order or contested order or alternative order in the offing. War is a reflection of that lawlessness. I then had the privilege of working very closely with two whom I know this audience will know well, Cyrus Vance, the former U.S. Secretary of State, David Hamburg, the former head of Carnegie Corporation of New York. Mary was associated with this work at many points along the way, as were a number of other distinguished international civil servants, on the question of how do we prevent mm-hmm. war from occurring? How do we prevent mass violence? How do we prevent this assault on the rule of law? We act too often as human beings as if war is the weather, that it just happens. But war is not the weather. War is a choice.